How's it going, everyone? It is Panjano here, and in this video we'll be covering one of the largest updates we've ever seen to Nvidia GPUs. This video will be showing you step by step how you can enable DLSS4 support with the new Transformer model in many of your favorite games through the official Nvidia settings. This can absolutely transform older titles which have outdated versions of DLSS, bringing them to the brand new Transformer model, which is the largest update DLSS has seen since the 2020 release of DLSS2. It's absolutely fantastic, and if you haven't seen DLSS4 for yourself, follow the steps in this video to enable this in many of your favorite games. And this video will also be covering the custom scaling options, which are now available as of this week, which lets you set the exact amount of DLSS that you want in any of your supported games. So you don't need to use the typical presets. You could have DLSS applied anywhere from 33% all the way up to 100%, so you can dial in the exact amount of DLSS that you want in many of your favorite games. Get Windows activated for a great price with Who Keys. Use the links below for Windows 11, Windows 10, or Office. Apply code PAN20 at checkout for an additional 25% off. Secure payment options, including PayPal, are available. Once complete, just paste the key to activate Windows and remove the watermark. Windows 10 keys can also upgrade to Windows 11. Use the links in the description below, and thank you to WhoKeys for sponsoring. All you need is an Nvidia RTX GPU, whether it's old, new, desktop, laptop. The game you want to enable this on has to have some level of DLSS settings in the game already, as we're just overriding it with the latest version of DLSS, the latest version of the Nvidia app, which if you've got it downloaded, just open up, it will automatically update, and the latest Nvidia GPU drivers. This is important to unlock the custom scaling option, otherwise it won't be present. Once you've updated to the latest GPU drivers and the latest version of the Nvidia app, we're now good to go ahead and set up DLSS4 on many of your favorite games. To do this, all we need to do is navigate down to the bottom left-hand side, go to the graphics panel, go to program settings. We can then find a list of all supported games on your system. The only other requirement for this to work is that the game you want to do this on must already support some iteration of DLSS in the game settings, which we can then override with the latest DLSS4 model. It's also worth noting that this isn't just available in single player games, it's also available in many of your favorite multiplayer titles such as Marvel Rivals, Call of Duty Black Ops 6, or other games that may have native DLSS support such as Overwatch 2. So for this example, I'm going to use Red Dead Redemption. Once you've selected the game you want to manually update to DLSS4, all we then need to do on the right-hand side is scroll down towards the driver settings. To update this and override it to DLSS4, go to the DLSS Override Model Preset section. If you would like to get more information regarding your specific game, you can click the information icon. To change this over to DLSS4, go to the right-hand side of this to Edit. Go to Use Same Settings for DLSS Technologies, go to the drop-down menu and set this to Latest. Go to the bottom right-hand side and select Apply. And it's just that simple and easy to set up. To show you an example, I have Red Dead Redemption currently running in its stock form with the version of DLSS the game currently ships with when you download it and launch it. On the bottom left-hand side, I have an advanced DLSS overlay which you can enable, and I will show you how to enable this later on in the video if you would like to monitor this for yourself. But as you can currently see, the game is utilizing DLSS version 3, and it's using 3.7.0. Now this isn't massively outdated, but this is DLSS 3, and it's using the old CNN model, which does not look as good as DLSS 4. You can also see what resolution I'm scaling from and to, and the render preset that's currently being used. I've already gone over to my Red Dead Redemption settings, I've gone to the model presets, and I've selected to use the same settings and selected latest, loading back into the exact same game, changing no other settings, using my DLSS indicator overlay in the bottom left. You can now see that the DLSS version has been updated, and it's marked as version 3.10.2.1, which is known as DLSS 4, and it's using the latest preset, which is preset K. And for me personally, sitting here in front of this image without any further encoding, there is a massive visual leap. And this game has now successfully been updated to utilize the latest version of DLSS 4. So just to make sure that you know exactly how to do that, we'll run through that exact same example, but with GTA 5 enhanced. I've booted into the game with no additional Nvidia settings adjusted. This is just the stock experience with DLSS quality enabled in the game. It's quite hard to see under the overlay because of the minimap, but if you look in the bottom left-hand side, you can see that it's currently using DLSS version 3.7.10 and it's using preset E. So this is a clear indication that this game is using DLSS version 3. So to manually update this game, all I need to do is just exit out, go to program settings inside of Nvidia, select GTA 5 enhanced or whatever game you're looking to apply this on. Scroll down in the settings until you find the driver settings tab, go to DLSS override model presets, go to the drop down menu for this, select use all same settings and select latest. select apply, and that's it. Once I've rebooted the game with the changes applied in the Nvidia app, if I now move, you can just about see in the overlay in the bottom left hand side under the minimap, that's another game which has now manually been updated to DLSS 4, even though it shipped with an older version by default. Now, one thing you may be noticing is that there is slightly lower FPS on the DLSS 4 Transformer model than the older versions of DLSS, but this does come with a massive visual increase. But don't be too worried about the FPS impact just yet, because the DLSS 4 Transformer model, whilst it looks a lot better, it also looks a lot better at lower presets. So if you were previously using DLSS 3 at quality, you may now be able to utilize DLSS 4 at balanced or even performance. Not only that, but the latest update, which literally came out yesterday, and many of your favorite games, you may be able to set custom internal resolution tuning for DLSS so you can set the exact amount that DLSS is going to scale. This could be anywhere from 95%, 90%, 33% to really dial in the experience for both FPS and visuals for your game. So now that I've gone down to use DLSS 4 performance mode, you can still see it's using preset K and the latest version in the bottom left hand side, and we've now successfully updated another game to DLSS 4. If you would like access to the DLSS overlay to monitor your current DLSS settings or any changes that you make in the bottom left of your games, it's super simple and easy to turn both on and off, and you don't need to download anything extra. All you need to do is go into Windows, press the Windows button, search for Reg Edit, then select the Registry Editor. We're simply going to be adding in one instance to the Registry Editor to enable the overlay. It's super simple, so don't panic. For this, we need to go to HKEY Local Machine, go to Software, double click, we're going to scroll down to Nvidia Corporation, Global, and last go to NGX Core. If you're not sure if you're in the correct location, just make sure that your directory matches this one at the top of my screen. On the right hand side in the blank space, navigate to New, DWORD 32-bit value. You then need to call this Show DLSS Indicator. Then press Enter. Once that's completed, double click, change this to Decimal Value, and set the value data to 1024. Make sure that this is set to decimal value, then select OK. Once that's completed, next time you boot into any of your favorite games and enable DLSS support in the game, you should then see the overlay in the bottom left. Now, if at any time you wish to turn this overlay off and disable it on your system, go back to the exact same location where you enabled it. So again, follow this path. Go over to the Show DLSS Indicator, right click, and just select Delete. Select Yes, and exit out. And just like that, you've now disabled it. We can now look into extended support for DLSS to be able to force non-supported modes such as DLAA, ultra performance, or even custom internal resolution scaling modes through DLSS. So let's say you're playing a game. For this example, I'll utilize Battlefield 2042. Inside of the game options, there is no way that I can set DLAA, even though the game supports DLSS. DLAA is just DLSS, but applied at the native resolution, so 100% resolution scaling, which results in a fantastic looking image. So if I wanted to force enable DLAA in Battlefield 2042, first, make sure that model presets has been set to latest, just like we did before. Select apply, but this time on any game that supports it, we can navigate down to DLSS Override Super Resolution. Click on the setting for this, we can then select from a few different forced presets. So if you wanted to use Ultra Performance but the game doesn't support it in the settings, you can simply select Ultra Performance in here, but for me I want to go with DLAA instead of Battlefield 2042, so I'll select apply. If you wanted to go with custom scaling, so you can set the exact amount of DLSS you want, all you need to do is set it to custom. If the custom option is missing, you need to make sure that you're running on the latest Nvidia GPU driver for this option to become available. If you wanted 90% DLSS in the game, you can set 90, you could go to 95. It really is up to you, and you can dial this in and find the exact settings that you like in any of your favorite games. So for example, I want DLAA on Battlefield 2042, and I'll apply that. But for Red Dead Redemption, I fancy utilizing 80% DLSS. So I'll go with custom and 80. If I boot Battlefield 2042, the game will be forced to use DLAA. And if I boot Red Dead Redemption, the game will be forced to use DLSS at 80%. With DLAA enabled in Battlefield 2042, if I just boot into the game, if you're forcing one of these specific modes of DLSS, this will be the only mode that can be applied to the game when you have it enabled in the Nvidia app. Every single one of these modes is just going to utilize the custom mode I selected, which for me was DLAA. So if I set this to performance now in the game, it's still utilizing that forced mode, which for me is DLAA at 100% render resolution. Let's say I set this to balanced, go back. You can see it's still utilizing the exact same DLSS forced mode that I enabled in the Nvidia app, because all modes of DLSS in that game then become the one that you forced. If you want this to go back to stock behavior so you can select between the modes in your game, then all you would do is select the game that you've forced the custom mode on for, go to the override super resolution mode, and just set this back to use 3D application default and select apply. When you reboot your game, you'll then be able to take control of DLSS modes in the game itself, like you typically would. So again, just something to remember if you do force a custom mode of DLSS. As I was showing you before, we're now utilizing DLAA in Battlefield 2042, even though the game doesn't support it, giving us the best possible visual quality for this game, which wasn't achievable before this update. If you would like to further extend support for DLSS4, enable these settings easier, or enable these settings on games that aren't supported in the Nvidia app, I will have an advanced DLSS4 video coming to the channel in just a few days, so make sure that you are subscribed to be notified immediately once that goes live. In some circumstances, when you enable DLSS4 in certain titles, going with the latest preset may not always give you the best results with the new Transformer model. If you find that your game still has ghosting issues or the image isn't ideal, instead of going with latest, if you select preset J, you may get better results in those games. Preset J was the original preset which shipped with the Transformer model found in DLSS4, so it could give you better results in some use cases. I want to cover whether or not you should be making use of DLSS4 in certain games. I like to play Red Dead Redemption on this PC at 4K with an RTX 4060, which is a pretty weak GPU at 4K. If we utilize the stock implementation of DLSS, which the game ships with, you can see when utilizing the DLSS performance mode on both versions of DLSS, you can see there is a pretty big FPS difference. DLSS4 does look a lot better, but it does come with a performance penalty. Depending on your setup and how far away your monitor is, the rendering resolution that you're using, and the GPU, you might want to stick with the stock implementation of DLSS on certain games if the highest FPS value is what you're looking for. DLSS4 will nearly always look way better than 3 or previous versions, but it won't perform as well. So whether you're looking for super high FPS or better visual quality or a mix of the two, boot the game in its stock settings, see how it performs, update it to DLSS4. If you like how it looks and you don't mind the slight performance impact, then keep it. Next up is something very important, especially if you're tuning your games on a per game basis to get the best performance or best visual quality when using DLSS. I'll show you two examples. They're at the exact same frame rate. One is utilizing DLSS4's Transformer model at the performance preset, and the other is utilizing the DLSS4 E preset, which is using the old CNN model, but at a resolution scale of 85% of 4K, and they perform the exact same. In Red Dead Redemption 1 on this RTX 4060, this is a great example as to why you should be setting up DLSS on a per game basis, so you can set up the exact preset and the exact model that works best for that game and the results in which you're looking for. One option isn't necessarily better than the other, it just depends on what you're looking for and what visual preferences you have. If you wanted to set this up on your games to see which performs best or which you want to go with, in this example for Red Dead 1, instead of going with the latest preset, I'm actually going to scroll down. Setting this to preset E will give us the latest version of DLSS, but with the E preset, which uses the faster CNN model. And with that, I'm then going to access the custom scaling options for DLSS, and I'm going to set this to either 80 or 85%. Again, you can set this anywhere from 33 to 100. Apply that to the game. I can then boot into Red Dead Redemption, and I'm getting this beautiful experience on an RTX 4060 with well over 60 FPS. Utilizing the latest preset with the Transformer model for DLSS4 will often give you the best results, but in some use cases, like here on Red Dead Redemption 1, it is worthwhile just adjusting per game settings to dial it in for that specific game so you always get the best results if you're willing to put in an extra few minutes. If at any point you want to revert any of the changes you've made throughout this video and you want to go back to the stock settings with the standard version of DLSS that the game supports, all you need to do is go to the game that you've changed the settings for, go down to the driver settings. If you enabled the override for model presets, go to the top setting and just change this to use 3D application setting, select apply. And if you changed any custom scaling options under DLSS override super resolution, scroll to the top and just select use 3D application, and select apply again. So you can easily go back and forth between the two to see if you prefer DLSS4 or the previous version, depending on whether you're looking for a better visual experience or better performance. Here is an example of Battlefield 2042's built-in anti-aliasing, which you cannot disable. And on the right-hand side, we have Nvidia's DLSS4 forcing the DLAA preset, which wasn't available in the game by stock. If we zoom in, you can see a quick comparison as just to how clear DLAA is compared to the stock implementation. So to conclude this video, what DLSS settings do I recommend? Well, definitely set them up on a per game basis to ensure that you can get the best results out of each individual game, whether you're looking for more FPS with the CNN model, or you're looking for better visual results with the Transformer model. Do bear in mind that you can utilize the extended DLSS modes and custom scaling on both the older, faster CNN model and the new Transformer model. And I like to go with anywhere from 70 to 85% if I'm using preset E. I use the latest DLSS in some games and I use preset E on some games. It really comes down to the game and the FPS I'm looking to get. It's all about fine-tuning this, and hopefully this video has showed you exactly how you can do that for your game so you can find the results that work best for you. For now though, let me know of your results utilizing DLSS4 in some of your favorite games, how you're finding the FPS or the visual increase, and what custom settings are you going with or recommendations do you have. Thank you ever so much for taking the time to watch this video, and I'll see you in the next one.